You know, the fact that the diamond weapons are also vertically at different positions, like there's one of them at top, on top, and one of them at below the other ones, makes their size and attack animations kind of silly looking. at all this stuff I'm getting. So many level ups, so many materia were born, and I even learned to limit breaks. Yeah, I was talking about the rising sun before, because that's actually a weapon for Jaffy, that's not garbage. Normally diamond weapon gives you 3500, because I fought 6 of them, I got 6 times as much, so 21,000. You know, in the original game, the most AP you get in a battle is 50,000 from beating an ammo weapon. Rufus surely has changed. Yeah, I think you cannot get more than 65,535, so 2 to the power of something minus 1. Even knew that the weapons have like some sort of blood inside. Also, if something that big like dies, you know, it used to be on the world map. Where did that decaying corpse, that carcass, even remain? I mean, if they have like a weapon model for it, where did it end up? Like, did some hobos just come and scavenge it? Was it eaten so quickly by crows that also, did some chocobos just fly around there? Yes, I have Knights of the Round. I have a couple of those. Okay. It's jump rope time again, but Sephiroth isn't really that adept at jump roping, it seems. People in charge of Shinra really have become quite robotic lately. Oh look, Hojo is actually secretly Cloud in a wheelchair in disguise. Who would have thought? I mean, the jump rope is really going quite crazy right there, isn't it? Like, who's gonna jump that fast? I mean, no wonder Sephiroth doesn't even try. Oh, hey, L-Body. Have you seen this for the first time? Because then this might indeed be a bit unusual. It's a shame you just missed 6 diamond weapons in one battle. lots of models in there. That was quite crazy, but surprisingly there's a lot of other scenes that are just as ridiculous. You know, I wasn't even aware of that, but you know, when you Kotter is still Kotter. It still deals the damage of Kotter, but the animation is Bahamut. So it's actually kind of nice because it's shorter now. Her weapon is not long reach. That's weird. How come she cannot attack? Is that not a long range weapon? Hey Phenomical, how are you? that's weak. I don't even get an ultimate weapon, but alright, who needs that anyway? You know, interestingly, this pink tentacle, that model, is actually used in the ancient forest. It's used when you swing at the top of the screen from one part to the other. It almost looks like they're just dropping their garbage onto Midgar, like a snowboard and stuff. I mean, I do not condone pollution of the environment. Please don't just throw your garbage out of an airship. Oh look, there is a chocobo carriage. I mean, sometimes these models are invisible, so it's kind of good that I know where everything is. Yeah, that's one of the things I don't like about FF7 is that there is only limited space for materia. It's not even that much, it's only like, I think 280 or so. And that already includes putting materia on your other characters. Actually, they were all dead. It's just that they died, but you didn't see the death animation because the attack that killed them, which in this case was Beta, because of how animations are randomized, it uses the attack animation of Death Force, and Death Force is normally only a single target attack. So if you attack an enemy with an attack like Beta that has the animation of a single target attack, enemies that die from it, or that even take damage or any effects from it, that is not visually displayed because of the mismatch of the animation. By the way. I mean, Don Corneo has a somewhat harder time climbing up ladders, if you can see. He doesn't seem to be quite in shape for all this ladder climbing. Thank you. Astro, you are going to work. Then have fun. Thank you. I try to not die. You do the same. Just had a spooky dream that your mother moved your whole family into your apartment. How big is your family anyway? Because that might be of relevance to how spooky it was. Yeah, that doesn't sound like fun. That sounds indeed quite like a bad dream. I mean, what is that dream supposed to tell you? You know, if I were a psychoanalyst and you believed in psychoanalysis, it would probably tell us something about your relationship with your mother. Also, Cloud deals MP damage. Cloud's Wagnarok weapon doesn't actually deal HP damage, it only deals MP damage. I see you. Are they all gonna flare me now? Please, dude, stop it. I mean, at least it seems like it's not gonna kill her because the damage is going increasingly lower. It seems to be some sort of percentage attack. You know, Bloodfest is essentially just a weaker version of Doom of the Living. Very interesting. Can you just leave Cloud alone? He's having a hard time moving in his wheelchair. You know, it's funny how the same model is used twice. Like, someone in my party is this chocobo or a skull, and someone in their party is too. Yeah, there was also a key, but. I guess that's to be expected, really. Also, I'm currently a draw. And who even is that? Is that normally Tifa? I mean, we'll never find out because it's gonna be Sephiroth. Could be just about anyone, really. So what is this leak supposed to tell me? Like, did someone spill their coffee there, or where's that coming from? Trains eject waste on the floor. You know, that's probably right, and that's kind of a spooky thought. It says nail beds, I hope. Like, a lot. That is not. Okay, it's actually W item. Because I cannot properly function without W item. What would also be really nice to have would be slash all materia or mega all, none of which I currently have. I wonder if I will still get any of that. Hey Fiffle, you come bearing cheese cards. Well, that's nice. What is this? Oh, there's a train leaving the building. Oh, I think I remember something. Just for fun. Oh yeah, I thought that was gonna happen. And it is indeed happening, but not right now, I think. Goodbye. Goodbye. It has been awfully long since we last had a random weapon encounter, hasn't it? Why is he there? Because enemy encounters are also randomized. This is not like, this happened a few times during this playthrough. Like, before I even left Midgar, I had run into every weapon except for Diamond Weapon. I had seen Emerald, Ruby, and Ultimate Weapon. Yeah, I mean, generally I still get the same enemies, but there are some unexpected surprises. Also, what is this? No, I have not killed Emerald Weapon yet. I've only killed Ultimates. I've killed one Ultimate Weapon and six Diamond Weapons. And I'm a dragon. I am EDK, the Evil Dragon King. I mean, I guess I could kill Emerald Weapon just for fun, because it's a random encounter here, provided I can do that. How would I kill Emerald Weapon anyway? Well, Emerald Weapon can't be in formation of six, because in a battle you can only have six enemies at most, and because if you fight Emerald, he has his eyes, so that's already four eyes, and Emerald, that's five. And actually in the Emerald Weapon fight there is an invisible enemy. You know, Emerald Weapon is actually only like his upper half. His legs are like another invisible enemy that are only there to make, you know, for visual reasons. So if you fight Emerald Weapon, you are already fighting six different enemies. There's no more room for any. You would have to like remove either like the invisible legs or some of his eyes to fight more of the more of Emerald Weapon. Hey Titsu. What is he even doing? He's making some sort of... you just got done watching the remake, so you'd watch someone else play it? Who played it if you didn't, because you just watched? With any of the challenge modes, you mean like no items or no materia, etc.? No, I have not. I could do so, but have you tried any of those? I guess the most straightforward one would be no materia, because materia is your main source of being overpowered. So I'm currently wondering if I should try and kill Emerald Weapon just for the fun. I mean, I guess I could try that. Doesn't even have any weapons that have 8 slots. Wow, he's complete garbage. I have way too much useless materia. Why do I have so many manipulates? All of these morphs, who needs them? Worst of all sense. Unfortunately, you can only put materia in the trash. Tifa is not big and is not small enough. She's such huge trash that my trash can just doesn't have any more room for Tifa. Unfortunately. I have, I mean, it's only 3 quattro, it's not like I have 16. So I have a question. Don't I have a misdial? Wait, it said I had gotten a misdial. Didn't I get that? Maybe not. I mean, how would you even do a materia only playthrough? What would that even mean? So what could possibly go wrong, right? I also don't have enemy lure or preemptive or speed plus materia. I have a lot of, there's a lot of stuff I don't have. I mean, I don't mind there being a missable item. I mean, there is quite a few missable items actually. This is basically Demi, only shorter. It's the same like all. It depends on the stars of the Quadra Magic materia. So if you have a mastered Quadra Magic, it's very useful. Because you can use it 5 times for the same spell. What do you mean by is everything fire? The animation is of fire, yes, but it's lightning elemental, that's because it's still bold, but the damage is actually more like Demi. It deals percentage damage, now fire, so it's relative, it's respective to the enemy's HP, and because Emerald Weapon has a million HP, this deals basically 999, even though on other enemies it might deal much less. At least I got a lot of AP. That's neat. You know, and I could fight this thing as many times as I want to because it's a random battle here. But, I mean, once you've seen it one time, I guess you've seen it as many times as you really want to see it. Also, because AP is randomized, this materia, Knights of the Round, in this randomizer now requires around 600, around 700,000 AP to master. Normally it's only 500,000. I don't like that. Oh, I could have tried to morph Amarip. Yeah, that's a good point. I didn't do that. I have not had any oatmeal today, but I've had water. There is an oatmeal bot? Really? Are you sure? I've never heard of that. I mean, I know of this water bot, hydration bot, but oatmeal bot seems new to me. Are you sure? I mean, I really cannot tell if you're joking or if you're not joking but being serious. It's kind of difficult. It sounds kind of interesting. Joking around is not your style. I mean, I'm sorry, but I just don't know your style that well, I'm afraid. How is it shaming to say that I just do not know someone's style very well? You can't just call everything shaming these days. It's not how it works. I mean, I could say stop shaming my shaming. Stop shame-shaming. If I want to shame someone, why are you shaming me for that? This was great. You saw a mod today. What is that called? This is almost as great as what we saw a few seconds ago. Oh, I see. Ouchu. You know, there's a model for Prodcourt. I wonder what it's gonna be. He looks constipated. There is no one to be seen. What the fuck just happened? Did someone just throw a Jaffy out of the window? There is a frog. And there is some own village excavation person. Who are hovering in mid-air. Okay, this is good because it's 5 prod clots. I actually saw them earlier in this playthrough, but I couldn't kill them because they just had too much HP. Why is she so weak? I think Jaffy just shouldn't attack anymore. I don't want to use that. Be no fun. Wow, that's a lot of damage. But that gives me a limb break, I think. Well, Knights of the Round actually has the Bahamut summoner animation now, so it's not even that much of a long animation anymore. I should have given Cloud something. Also, they each have around 100,000 HP, just like Diamond Weapon. Also, I think Megalixirs do not really work anymore, at least not in battle, like, because also their effect is random. They do not actually recover anymore. Well, they only affect AP, MP, yeah. Megalixirs are basically just Turbo Ethers and all now, which is complete garbage. What about Elixirs? This kind of works, I guess. Thank you. Don't I have like any useful wear items, maybe? Wow, this even heals this thing. I'm not sure how that's possible, but whatever. I'm kind of afraid to even use this now. Seems like the animations for attacks are not that randomized. Maybe not all items have randomized attack animations. I mean, yeah, even elixirs or mega elixirs I used have randomized attack animations. Maybe just some items couldn't be randomized. Well, if only I had a better limit break, though, to mine. She killed the Jama armor. part of prod clots. There's one of these armors and 5 prod clots, so 6 enemies in total. Also, I realized to save everyone some time, it's probably best to still use this. And now I hope that. Oh wow, it didn't even softlock. I'm almost surprised. Wait, did I get Mr. now? You know, also who can equip weapon and armors and accessories has been randomized. So Cloud can equip the missile. Jaffy can equip the missile, but Tifa cannot equip the missile. It doesn't. Oh, well, actually she can. But someone might not be able to equip the missile. Maybe that's an exception, but like there's armor that only one that some characters cannot equip, or accessories that someone cannot equip. Oh yes, for example, the curse ring. Like Cloud can equip the curse ring, and Jaffy already has it, but Tifa cannot equip the curse ring. It doesn't show up in her menu, and. At the same time, Jaffy cannot equip the ribbon, which is not good. Yeah, I mean, also champion belt and probably just about anything, really. It's kind of annoying, really. I know, for weapons it's, I mean you can configure it in the randomizer settings, but I chose to have weapons only, you know, for the characters for whom they are made, because the issue is that if you give, like, which you can do by modifying the game data and randomizing it, if you give Cloud, for example, weapons from Tifa, or if you give any character weapons that they normally cannot equip, because the model doesn't really show up in battle, it will give them their default weapon net model, so if Cloud has any other weapons than his own weapons, he will always have the weapon animation of the model from his Buster Sword. So it's kind of dull, really, to give him, like, visually, it always just shows him as if he were wielding the Buster Sword, which is a bit disappointing, so I decided not to do that. Oh yeah, I just realized why her weapon deals shit damage, because I unequipped, which I should not have done. Your Buster Sword used the dice formula of Kate's Save on a Siege. That's very interesting. I mean, I guess like early on, it was probably very powerful, wasn't it? If you even had the Buster Sword early on. Sounds interesting. I mean, like that, the early game must have been really pushover territory. You know, in this case, Juffy's current weapon, the Twin Viper, uses Barret's missing score damage formula. So the more AP it has in the weapon slots, the more damage she deals. That's why I gave her all this mastered materia. I mean, this randomizer only really works, or it only really is interesting, or I find it to be most enjoyable if you have like a way to look into the game data so to know what your stuff even does. I mean, you could also just, it could be fun to just not even know what your equipment does, but I kind of prefer to look up this stuff. I mean, I still hear the sound effects myself, but they are quite very low volume, aren't they? So this is a non-revisitable location, and for that it's actually quite good grinding spots. So what is Tifa's? I gave her the premium heart, but she's not really doing that much damage. I should give her the power soul. Yeah, I should give her the power soul. This is a bit glitched, I think. This is actually even worse, isn't it? Oh look, we have some cute frogs now. I mean, this weapon is not really good either. Doesn't Tifa have anything good? Like, how about the diet? Well, that's even worse. Tifa doesn't have any good weapon, it seems. Why is this all so terrible? I mean, this has an attack power of 6. Are you kidding me? Wait, what did I say about the work glove again? I think I might be better off actually with the premium art. Hey Jenna Kurono. So I need to check something. I'm just looking up some information right now. I'll be back in a second. Okay. These light beams are the most disappointing enemy models. I've seen them quite a few times throughout this run. This playthrough, I've seen like yellow light beams, purple ones. I don't even know where they are normally used. But, I mean, I find propellers not that bad compared to light beams. I mean, they're not exactly exciting either, but... I think there's four Hojos. I just realized I saw part of a third one, and oh yeah, there's four. They look a bit like Michael Jackson, actually, from like the 90s. I mean, minus the green skin. Is this a soft lock? I wonder. Oh, never mind. I think this battle just has weird loading times. Thank you. Yeah, and I think all Hojos are dead now. Finally. Maybe. Oh. You know, last time was more fun. There was more Hojos. Well, see you positive, Abyss Lords, and have a good day as well. I mean, at least this doesn't disappoint. I mean, it's not quite six though, but... Actually, it is six, I just cannot see them all. You know, silence has an astonishingly impressive looking animation. And they're all gonna count over silence, aren't they? We're gonna see this six times. Also, I just realized I was kind of looking forward to Cloud using Omni Slash, but then I realized because his weapon deals. I mean, is he gonna deal MP damage or not with Omni Slash? I don't even know right now. No, I don't think they do. Also, he's not having the Heaven's Cloud, but this is the Ragnarok. So this should be good. Well, it's actually quite simple, you know. The Ragnarok looks nice, the Heaven's Cloud looks terrible. Well, the Apocalypse is magenta. It's almost like the it's the color of the Limit Break box bar. Do they counter every magical attack with silence? Because that's terrible. Well, this took a while. You know, some people give subs to just random people in chat. I mean, maybe you were just left, or maybe, I mean... Or maybe it's some sort of promotion. I have gotten... Yes, actually I had 4 gold chocobos. Because I was able to find an enemy that morphed into a desert rose, and I got 5 desert roses. So I got 5 gold chocobos, one of which is still actually in Khan because I didn't have room in my chocobo stable. Oh, hey, Porch Messi. Well, if I believe some stories, then quite a few dudes are able to romance a red piece of paper. And all of a sudden they put on more clothes, not less clothes. I mean, this game is actually quite sensible because it can get cold in the morning, so you should probably put on more clothes. Thank you. What the fuck are those characters? Oh, look, I now have a soccer ball in my party, and Marlene is there, and the homeless hobo from the slums. Oh, and there's the shark. Don't forget the shark. And some robots. I'm not exactly sure what Zack is doing there, but it looks a bit spooky. So where did they even drop their stuff? I mean, they kind of just irresponsibly dropped the stuff from the Hyrule somewhere into wherever they were going. Oh, it's nice that we have a helicopter inside this airship. Pieces fell on the villagers' local McDonald's. I mean, that sounds terrible. I hope that that McDonald's didn't burst into flames because of that. I mean, we certainly wouldn't want that, now would we? Hyper is quite the appropriate item to get here. So like, should I kill ammo weapon one more time? Is it even still there? I'm not even sure. Like, can I even kill it one more time? did killing it in the Shinra headquarters like have an effect on this emerald weapon? Maybe like I killed it for good and now it's like actually not there anymore. I that would be a bit sad. I have a feeling it's not there anymore. Oh well. Yeah, I think it's not there anymore. Which actually would kind of make sense, because when you kill it, it has like as its in its AI scripts as its like death counter, which is triggered when it's dead, when it's killed. It updates some sort of global variable to make it remove it from the world map, because you're normally only supposed to kill it once, so I guess that's that. So I can only kill the ruby weapon at this point. Also, I forgot, where do you pick up where's the spot for the key to Sector 5? Somewhere here it says. That's not what I wanted. So why does some random NPC even have that key to Sector 5? Also, what is Aerith doing? She's she's like some sort of spider. She's just crawling all over the screen. It's actually a bit spooky. Ah, look, there's the ghost Zack. Yeah, there was the amazing rock boulder from the Temple of the Ancients. So I'm just gonna find out if there's actually, if there is the right number of ruby weapons in this fight, or if I need to do something, because if it's not six ruby weapons, I'm not gonna do this. I mean, no, this is just not enough ruby weapons. It's not enough ruby weapons. Clearly. So I just have to fix this one moment. I mean, last time I fought six, I'm not settling for any less than that. Yes, I fought ammoed weapon as an encounter, a random encounter, in the Shinra headquarters, and I killed it there. So apparently, if you kill it one time, you cannot encounter it. Even if you encounter it just as a random encounter, you cannot encounter it more than once. Or you cannot kill it more than once. So, currently in the process of making me fight more of ruby weapon. I mean, I can, because ruby weapon has four has two tentacles, I can have four ruby weapons. I wonder how to arrange them in a nice way, because that's also very important. We cannot just, you know, ignore that. So that's three, but one more, maybe like on top. I think that's good. Let's do that. This should be good. Oh yeah, it's a nice square of ruby weapons. Yeah, isn't this just beautiful? I mean, the fact that I'm dying is maybe not quite that beautiful, but... So there is enough ruby weapons. I just need to kill them now. So I'm gonna do the standard strategy of killing two of my party members so that they are dead and I can then enter the fight with ruby weapon with two characters already killed. Now for that I need to just kill two characters. Which is probably not gonna work like this. My strategy. I mean, interestingly, I have W Summon, which could be of some use. I can cast Phoenix. Then I can cast Hades. And then I guess I'm just gonna do the old reliable Vincent Smuglitch. Also, which weapons even work with darts? I need to look that up. I guess I can just try and see how this goes. But I like this color. I cannot fight under such a hideous sky. I guess I'm just gonna enter this house for like as many times until I find this all kind of pretty. Oh yeah, this works. You know, seeing four ruby weapon heads kind of makes me realize this game can be quite spooky. That was not a good idea. That was not a good idea. Also, how did Vincent just die? I cannot say I understand that. This looks interesting, it's just a pile of wet goo. Oh well. Whatever, I guess. Also, I'm not even sure if I really just got 180,000 XP and 200,000 AP. I don't know if I can trust this game. In fact, I don't think I can trust this game because I'm pretty sure I didn't get that stuff. I think I got like nothing. I think I got like a hot, juicy bucket of absolutely nothing. AP wise at least. Then again, it said something had was mastered and was reborn. So this is kind of weird. So this is like a bit too dark. Also, what is the point of these little hills anyway? I mean, you can land here and get here, but it's kind of pointless because there's nothing special up here. I mean, they could have like put some unusual enemy encounters on top of these mountains, but they didn't. This is too standard. This is too green and too dark. And still too dark. This is nice and bright, but it's not kind of pink enough. I mean, this just basically looks like a dusk. I mean, what a pretty dusk this is. Oh, interestingly, you can't actually get in here with the chocobo. I mean, you can put the high wind into this hole, but the chocobo doesn't want to go there, it seems. You know, it almost seems like there's a depth to the ocean. Like, here he sinks down entirely, but here he doesn't even sink. Interesting. Anyway, I am afraid I have to now hide in my bed for a few hours. And then maybe somebody can find me. So maybe you should try that too. It's a very fun party game. And try not to die either. And have maybe some spooky dreams and spooky food and maybe spooky games. Until the future. Goodbye.